What up, guys? Welcome to Sono Jr. playing some more WWE 2K15 Universe Mode. We're on episode 55, week 22 of NXT. And holy shit, I just came off an amazing special pay-per-view. Almost said Night of Champions again. Sorry. I'm really forgetting what it's called. Saturday Night's Main Event. That's what it's called. There you go. Saturday Night's Main Event was amazing. There was a couple matches out there. It was like, they went a little long than they had to go, but most of the night was really, really great. If you guys haven't seen it, it's the link in the description that takes you right to it if your booties are too lazy to click it. Other than that, let's get on with the night. This night is going to be amazing, hopefully. I have some plans as we're heading into the end of the year here, and I'm heading into, like, you know, other crazier pay-per-views in the night, and I really hope you guys do enjoy this NXT. It's going to be something. It's definitely going to be something, but let's get on with it. Kevin Owens takes on Daniels for the NXT Championship here tonight. Kevin Owens putting his championship on the line versus a very game Christopher Daniels. Up second, Cody Rhodes, Adrian Neville, and Rey Mysterio take each other on a triple threat match. Justin Guerrero makes his re-debut here tonight, as Baron Corbin makes his debut here tonight. They take each other on in our third match of the night. Bray Wyatt, R-Truth, Fandango, Kofi Kingston, Black Tornado, and Corey Graves take each other on in a battle royale six-man over the top rope. One of these men will get the next shot at Kevin Owens' NXT Championship next week. Tamina Snuka takes on Emma in a submission match. Tamina Snuka not very happy last time she took on Emma, and these two are willing to go at it again here tonight in a submission match nonetheless. Nikki Bella takes on AJ Lee yet again in our semi-main event. In our main event, Scott Mercury takes on Goldust. Goldust had an amazing match at a Saturday Night's main event versus Undertaker and Shawn Michaels, and even came out as victor of those three. I thought it was an amazing, amazing, amazing match. And if you guys, like I said, if you guys haven't seen Saturday Night's Main Event, please go check it out. It was so fucking good. Oh man, I had a fucking ball playing that shit. And a few matches were weird, but a lot of the matches were just really great. Let's get on with the first match of the night, as Kevin Owens takes on Christopher Daniels. NXT Championship, let's do this. Follow Scout Anywhere, let's go. Follow Scout Anywhere match. Hello. As Kevin Owens takes on Christopher Daniels here.
WWE's next breakout superstar. I'm Michael Cole, along with Jerry the King Lawler. And King, what do you make of this match?
Oh yeah, the WWE Universe is going to love this one. Nobody wants to
even kind of know each other from the indies. They're going to hopefully put on a spectacle here tonight. Oh, you'll realize that Kevin Owens is not the same guy that Christopher Daniels knows from the indies. I don't know if you guys have seen Unstoppable recently. I know this is going to go like a lot later than Unstoppable, but man, that pay-per-view was fucking ridiculous. Just crazy.
Look at these two jockeys.
It's crazy how long these two can fucking go in a fucking collar and elbow tie up here. Right now, Kevin Owens with the advantage over him. And Kevin Owens is a crazy motherfucker also, because he's putting himself in these stipulations and these matches where he's kind of challenging himself in a False Count Anywhere match where anything could happen. Anyone could step in and help Daniels here at this point. You know what I mean? Anyone could come in and try and stop Kevin Owens from winning this match tonight, and yet he still, you know, asks for a championship defense just about every week.
Telegraph, the superstar capitalizes.
I guess he's waiting for Sami Zayn to recover and get that fucking whatever he's got to get fixed, so we can take him on again and hurt him yet again. I mean, last time we saw Sami Zayn, it was on the ground gasping for breath as he got speared through a barricade. I mean, it wasn't anything great. Kevin Owens is no joke. He definitely is no joke. Super kick laying Daniels out flat. And right now, it doesn't seem like Daniels has anything going right now. So Kevin Owens is just smashing him up.
Oh my! And he's checking under the apron for something that can aid him in this no disqualification match.
It's not going to be good for Daniels, and he knows it. He knows it really well. He knows
everybody,
it.
There are no countouts.
Uh-oh.
His
Daniels?
Competitors can stay out.
Jeez.
Here, and he was just sent careening into those steel steps.
You got to give him credit for still staying in this, but man, he has no chance. He really has no chance. I mean, if anyone has a chance here,
these no DQ matches are
it's
so
Kevin,
dangerous.
Definitely Kevin Owens at this point. Kevin Owens has just been on a fucking rampage here. Oh, that may turn the tides around.
Oh, not again.
Doing work
not again.
Quick on those legs of Kevin Owens. Oh. Oh. Oh my gosh, Exploder again. Uh-oh. Reversal here. Oh, reversal here by Kevin Owens. I mean, sorry, what am I talking about? By Daniels. Daniels quick and easy putting that to work.
How do these superstars keep doing it? Oh, out of nowhere.
Reversal by Daniels again. Oh!
He saw that one coming.
No. No, he's not doing that. Kevin, what are you doing, bud? Oh my gosh! It's over. It's over. You heard the thud. It's... Oh! My gosh, Daniels kicked out. I didn't press shit. I didn't press shit. I swear I didn't press anything. That's fucking crazy. Jeez!
Directly on that table. You don't want to do this.
Move the fuck away, ref.
What an impact from that kick. Boy, he was able to reverse and get out of that.
Oh no! Oh my gosh.
Explosive suplex. Uh-oh, look at that.
No. Kevin, what are you doing, bud? Bud! You already saw it once. You gonna do it again? Jeez! Is that enough? 2, 3. Oh my gosh. Kevin Owens just decimated him. Okay, that's not what decimation is. But this right here. Look at this fucking move. He got him right on the fucking edge of the ladder. Oh my gosh!
And here's just some of the action.
Oh boy. He crashed right through that fucking
performance. Let's see some of the highlights.
Oh man. He just finished him off with authority twice.
NXT champion Kevin Owens.
Man, what a contest. We definitely just witnessed one for the ages.
I think it's the most action that table and ladder is ever gonna get, because I don't think they're gonna be in use anymore after the fucking Kevin Owens just smashed Daniels back through both of them, especially that table. The table is just, you can't do anything with a smash up table like that, but use it for firewood at this point. Holy shit, that was crazy. Quick and easy getting it done. Anyway guys, up next, Cody Rhodes, Rey Mysterio, and Adrian Neville take each other on. Triple threat match up next, only on NXT. Don't you dare click away. Alright, playing as Adrian Neville here. Anyone can win this match. It doesn't matter if it's just me or not. He just came off a fucking, like I said, amazing pay-per-view. But that match before this one was fucking insane. Did you see fucking Kevin Owens dominating that match just now? Oh my gosh. I mean, Chris Daniels was number one contender, but just had no chance. Oh. Oh, he caught the referee there. Caught the wrong guy.
Counter by Mysterio.
Imagine this. You're going to see a lot of bounces and flying around from these three. Oh, caught fucking Ray instead, but I think it's why he was running gold for us at some point. I mean, at some point, these three actually are going to fucking meet each other. And here they are right now in a triple threat match.
Dodges that one.
Using the strength this time to push Mysterio over.
The apron and down to the floor. Are you kidding me? Look. Reversal. Watch out.
Oof.
He whipped that one. Oh my gosh.
Oof.
What? Does he have his eyes open?
What the fuck?
Oh.
Damn it. It's so hard to hit your Adrian Neville's moves sometimes because he's so fucking fast. You gotta press it early. Oh! Rey Mysterio taking a page out of his book there. Oh, now he got him.
I think it's safe to say that one of the most special moments of Cody's career was when he teamed with his brother Goldust and beat the Shield.
Oh, again going for the legs there.
I don't think anyone, not even the Rhodes family,
oh shit! Cody and Dragorana, one, two.
So close. Rey Mysterio gets out. And remember, we still have that blockbuster main event tonight.
Oh, we've got him around the leg there, but he still got away with it. Oh. Oh, there we go. Mysterio taking advantage with a moonsault. Don't count Mysterio out just yet. Do not count Cody Rhodes out just yet. All it takes is a 619. Oh.
He got all of that super kick.
Or a crossroads to fucking finish this match.
You know, I don't think most fans ever thought Cody and Goldust would team up, but I think it's something their fans always hoped would happen. Cody and Goldust winning the tag team titles together was such a special moment for the family to remember.
Your ears itch the fuck out of me. Stop it.
The American dream. Let me remind everybody, there are no countouts. These competitors can stay out here as long.
Are you kidding me? Oh, my gosh. Neville just bounced off that fucking step there. How is he still getting up?
Look at this. Rey Mysterio doing some good work here.
Oh, as we've said many times, King, when you leave the ring, the match becomes incredibly dangerous.
Oh. Yeah, you're right. And I think the crash into that ring post summed that up.
Oh,
reversing.
What?
Adrian Neville showing his shot to the post. And he's heading
Neville.
Back in.
Oh my gosh, this kid's insane.
God, did you hear that impact?
And he missed at that.
I've been in this business a long time. And I've never, and I mean never, seen anyone take an audience on a wilder roller coaster ride than Rey Mysterio. It's like the fans know that Rey's opponents have to be ready for anything. And so do they.
Oh, he reversed yet again. And Rey Mysterio going for a diving kick there. Fucking Cody Rhodes reversed it. Oh my gosh, right on those steps. Mysterio.
Adrian Neville not letting up.
These three know what it takes to win a championship, and they will do anything for it yet again.
Nicely avoided there.
Oh shit. Oh shit.
Here we go. Outside of the ring, and there are no countouts in this match.
Mysterio with eyes in the back of his head knew that Neville was going to grab from there. Throwing him back into the ring is Mysterio. I still hate there's no reversal for that. I was thinking the other day when I was doing triple threats, I was like, why don't they have managers in triple threat matches, man? It makes shit so much more, like, crazy and shit. You know what I mean? Because it adds that manager role to it. Where managers, if managers hit a wrestler in front of a referee, he'd have, like, two chances to do it. And then this fucking... Oh! The third time, he'd get fucking... Well, the second time, he'd get fucking caught up. But I don't know. Physical. It was something that was going through my mind. I was like, why don't they have fucking... I don't know the exact rules yet, but I'm pretty sure they could figure some shit out.
Now back. Whoa, whoa!
Oh!
Ooh, and he got dropped.
Now we're going up again. This time I might be good. Second time around. Whatever. Now he's going for it. 450! Oh, no. He got all of it. What? How'd you miss that? Oh, I guess he's kind of short. How'd you miss that? I guess he's kind of short. Fuck it. German suplex! Going for the pin and a rope break. But yeah, they could work something out where they have like a manager there, and the manager has like a certain amount of rules where manager can't do too many bad things or whatever. You could have a diva take it as you as a manager too, but like, you know, if a wrestler hits the diva, it's all automatically over. At the same time, if a diva gets in the way, she gets kicked out. Like, it'd be kind of cool where you could have a manager in the way, giving you that extra boost, even in a triple threat match where you don't really need it, where they can throw a weapon in or something. Ooh. Oh my gosh, he just drop kicked the hell out of him right there, and Cody Rhodes now taking advantage.
Oh, finding a path of destruction currently.
Oh,
Watch it.
Oh, that was sick. Lateral press. No. That one kicks out of one. Disqualification match.
Rey Mysterio's in dire
straits. Oh, Tiger suplex.
He's going for the pin. He got in there. I thought it was it. I thought it was going to be over.
Oh, man. That's Bulldog. Simple and easy. Cutter was wasting no time there with that. Oh.
Uh-oh, look at this. Oh. Trying to put him away.
Oh, Hanzagiri.
Mysterio takes a hard shot.
Oh.
And the offensive display by Adrian Neville. Reversal. Adrian Neville showing his prowess.
Look at this. Oh.
What a maneuver. And there's the breakup, just in the nick of time. What a shot!
Wow, Cody Rhodes just timed that perfectly.
No! Oh!
Oh!
Oh, and he eats the canvas. He's in big trouble.
You know this guy's thinking something crazy every fucking time he does it. Oh my gosh, but you also gotta realize the strength and the flexibility of this guy at the same time. Oh, a spider suplex.
Adversity right now.
Remember, there are no countouts in this contest. This match could end up anywhere.
And he could have went for the red arrow there, but it may have not been a good idea for him to do, and Mysterio is still somewhat fresh in this point in the match.
Oh, this one should have been over, but he breaks the hold.
The fuck? Hit him! What the fuck are you doing?
Great move.
Oh.
The damage has definitely been done. Now it may just be a matter of time. Cody Rhodes delivering.
Oh, going stealing, going for the steal here, going for the steal. Referee, referee. One, two, three. Adrian Neville's neck is stuck in the rope, but he's took the victory. Get your ass out the way. Oh, man. This match was... I really wanted to see a red arrow, but I was like, man, it would have been here all night trying to wait for that shit. These two recover so fast, it's hard to get something like that done. They recover too fast at the point, at the moments you don't need to be, and then when you don't, when it's time for them to recover fast, they recover too slow. It's never a win-win, really.
Here is your winner.
Adrian Neville with the win here, trying to revitalize his self here, trying to get himself back in the fucking fray of championship gold. You never know, you could see him as NXT champion again. Anything is possible for this man. Anyway, guys. Up next, Justin Gabriel makes his re-debut as he takes on the debuting Baron Corbin. We'll find out who wins. Up next, only on NXT. Stay tuned! Playing as Baron Corbin here. Gabriel kind of getting himself back into this point, trying to get himself back into... Oh my gosh, already Baron Corbin dominating at this point. But Gabriel can turn it around. But Gabriel making his re-debut here. Tonight versus Baron Corbin also making his debut into NXT.
I think Gabriel's wings have been clipped in this one.
Oh, Gabriel kind of swinging, turning it around.
Wow, that might have broken his jaw.
Weren't expecting Baron Corbin to be knocked down so easily, but at the same time, expect nothing less from guys on NXT. It doesn't matter who it is, they also put on a good match. Oh my gosh, Baron Corbin again. Big time, big boot, wasting no time. Could Gabriel hit that 450, or will, be, or will it be his end of days? Oh! Presented to him by Baron Corbin here.
He knows his opponent is completely
going for the submission. And now you gotta realize that even though Baron Corbin is a strong man, he is a big man at that. And grounding someone like that and putting them in submission is hard as fuck for them to get back up. Oh my gosh. Showing the strength again. Shoulder switch. power slam. Shoulder switch side slam there. Actually, I think it would be a power slam. Fucking doubting myself when I talk about Gabriel wants to be. Oh my gosh. What diabolical things gotta give, gotta give this guy Gabriel right credit. He's fucking coming back and trying to get a win here. It's not easy for him. It's not easy after he's been out for a while. I'm pretty sure he's been in the gym, but that's not the point here. Oh my gosh. Strength. And the strength of fucking Baron Corbin is just no joke.
And he breaks the hold. I guess he
calf kick knocking down Baron.
I don't know what more you'd want to do to another man.
Baron just tossing him.
Strength.
Reversal by Gabriel here, though. You gotta give the guy credit. He's standing in. He's definitely standing in versus a very game Baron Corbin making his debut. He wanna. Oh my gosh! You wanna make an impression, and that's how you do it right there. Oh my gosh! A fucking giant big boot. This could be it. This could be it. End of days! He got him! But is it enough? Is it enough to take out Gabriel here? One, two, three. It's over. Corbin wasting no time getting things done here tonight. Quick and easy. My gosh. One, two, three. That's the only highlight you need. It was over. It was damn near over here. Let's get a closer up look, but it doesn't matter how close up you get. It's also, it's always, it's gonna be a three. I do a little few edits on a Baron Corbin's.
Here's your winner, Byron.
You see this shit, right? That's weird.
Love him or hate him, that was an incredible match.
You know, for his debut. Jeez. He just wants to scare the fans with his gums. Anyway, guys, up next, Bray Wyatt, R-Truth, Fandango, Kofi Kingston, Black Tornado, and Corey Graves take each other on in a six-man battle royal over the top rope elimination match. And the winner takes on Kevin Owens next week for Kevin Owens NXT Championship. So one of these lucky men will be the winner. We'll find out who it is. Up next, only on NXT.
R-Truth looks to be in amazing shape here tonight.
Yeah, you can bet he hasn't missed too many workouts. What do we got here?
Oh, you are getting tossed around. And our fan Daniel seems like he's going to be eliminated first. Keep himself in the match. Now, we haven't seen guys like Corey Graves and Bray Wyatt and R-Truth in a while, actually. I mean, and Kofi Kingston, for that matter, since
this could be bad.
They're not really part of the story right now. It's not that they're on the roster, but it's hard to get all these guys in one match, in a match per night. So, I got to treat like the indies and kind of just get with people that are in the story on TV.
He's still in this one.
Doing like house shows every night and shit.
Just so sneaky.
Oh my gosh. Oh.
No, not again. Oh, the punch connects.
Leg drop.
And there's the leg drop.
Everyone's getting bounced all over the place here. Corey Graves feeling it though. This Black Tornado guy is definitely no joke. Oh. Keeping himself in the match here. Amazing flexibility and speed.
What's our truth gonna do with this? What a kick that was. He's gonna destroy this man. Another neck breaker. Whoa.
Oh.
Just a little too slow there. And there's the
Black Tornado and R-Truth. And not R-Truth and Fandango having a lot of trouble on his debut. You know, Fandango's ready to show off and dance and you know, Black Tornado's all about having a good time, but when it was time to wrestle, he got into it. Spent no time on Fandango there. Both men eliminating R-Truth. Oh my gosh, he getting tossed around his head there. Reversal. Oh my gosh, this guy flies in the sky like a fucking. I don't know what he flies around like. It's fucking amazing.
Whoa, he's measuring.
Bray Wyatt eliminating him with ease.
Yeah, but you have to think Graves has taken something from this match that he can use in the future.
Oh! He was one step ahead on that one. And there's the reversal.
Oof.
He's fought out of it.
Bray is beat here. Bray is beaten. He's going for the elimination again.
Well, he was able to reverse and get out of that.
Oof, man. Look at that.
Why I really can't time that. That's not even good.
Oh, no.
I'm a fucking dummy right now for that. Oh, my gosh. He just caught right in the back there. R-Truth, R-Truth's been eliminated a while ago. They're all black. I'm not racist.
And he's still in this. Oh, back to the head. Back to the toe.
Oh.
What a shot.
Kofi Kingston also having always amazing matches in my universe mode. Wouldn't be surprised if he fucking shows off here tonight and gets eliminations on everyone. Fandango is eliminated, though. R-Truth. Sorry. Send R-Truth, goddammit. Fucking Kofi Kingston and Black Tornado. Eliminating Bray Wyatt. Now it's down to these two.
Wyatt's been eliminated. Good. Get him out of here. He freaks me out. Oh, out of nowhere.
Oh.
He gets out of trouble there.
Oh.
Oh, wait. Nice reverse.
Oh.
Oh, no.
Oh.
Oh.
Kofi Kingston is one of the most exhilarating performers WWE has ever seen. Kofi's a multiple-time Intercontinental Champion, United States Champion, and held WWE and World Tag Team Gold, too. And we can't forget Kofi's brilliance in the Royal Rumble and Money in the Bank matches. He was able to reverse that.
Uh-oh. Jeez, clothesline taking Kofi Kingston out.
Three eliminations. He's making his presence.
And he's taking control of this ring. What a win for Black Tornado. Black Tornado gets a chance next week to take on Kevin Owens for the NXT Championship. You know, just a few weeks ago, this guy was on the just starting in NXT here, and now he has a chance next week to take on Kevin Owens. Holy shit, you talk about turning the fucking tides here. And his chances seem a very... His chances don't seem that slim, it seems. It seems not for this guy. Black Tornado with an amazing victory. Oh man, up next. Tamina takes an eminent submission match. Let's get to it. Alright, playing as Tamina here. Take on Emma. Now, let this fucking. Let this guy talk
a big pressure. Controlling the head. Tamina going for it.
Hall and Noble tie up. These two are finding spots for each other here. And this the thing about these two is they don't know each other too well. But goddamn, they put on great matches. Last time these two were in the ring, it didn't go too well for Tamina here.
And she basically said, what do you expect? I practice and work hard, and I've earned everything I'm getting.
Oh, man.
Right now.
Look at that.
Been drawn to Emma.
She caught her. That was amazing.
With signs displaying her Emma-isms. And that was well before she ever stepped foot in a ring. You know, when you can command that type
back
of
again.
Attention, you know you're dealing with somebody special.
Oh,
Emma
another kick in the
to
back.
Punish her opponent.
Right now, Emma just taking control. Just like she did a few weeks ago versus Oaf.
Up the turnbuckle goes Emma.
Oof.
Oh,
that's where she got caught there. Tamina taking her time. I wish she could have super kicked her right on the fucking like knee and just knocked her, like buckled her knee up. Oh. Now, like I was trying to say earlier, we know that Tamina's very good in the ring. We know she's a very technical wrestler, but we do know that Emma knows a lot more in the submission game than Tamina. We haven't seen Tamina in a lot of submission matches in her career. We know that she's a hard hitter. She's a fucking, she moves fast as shit, but we've never really seen her put any submissions on. I never seen her make anyone tap out. I've seen Emma make constant people tap out.
I just don't know what it is.
Emma oh, go for that super kick again. Ow. Oh, she was going to cock back the fist there, as you can see. And now Tamina taking control here. Oh!
Oh, my!
Oh! Oh! The crowd does not like Tamina, and you can see here, you can see why the referee's in the fucking way.
If anyone ever forgets Emma's name, it's certainly not Emma's fault. Between the
Emma Mike sandwich, the dilemma, and Ben Emma, she's got her name tattooed almost every move she does, King.
Thanks for taking over there.
Reversal. Showing the balance, showing the strength. Tamina just taking control of this match right now. Seriously, she just, she's not getting, she's not giving Emma any ground here to get back on her feet until just now. Oh, right back down she goes. Going for this mission yet again. Cobra Clutch is simply easy. Did I say Cobra Clutch? I'm sorry, guys. Camel Clutch.
She's the one applying it.
Oh.
Oh.
She going this time. She got in the head. Fucking headbutt. Taking out Emma quick and easy here. Now she has the submission locked in again. It's going to be hard for me to get this fucking submission going. Reversal by Emma here, getting a little something here.
Well, that was some reversal by Tamina.
Oh!
What a move from Tamina. That's how you impress the WWE.
Now going for a single leg Boston Crab, getting her submission up here.
Tap out right here. Oh, you're not gonna last long here. Now it's time to fight out or tap out, King.
Reversal by Emma yet again.
Oof. Oh, Emma unable to be contained.
Every time Emma goes for something, Tamina has her well scouted.
Showboating going on here.
Wait a minute.
Again. Tamina not fucking spending any time with Emma here, trying to get rid of her as quick as possible. Keep that momentum going until the next pay-per-view. Oh my gosh. And Emma just took a horrible fall. And here comes Tamina. She's flying. Jeez. Trying to make a tap out as quick and easy as possible. And it's getting hard. It's getting harder and harder for Emma to stay in this every time. Look how OP. Dude, if I was at red, I swear I would have already tapped out. If I was at orange, I would have already tapped out. Like, this game is ridiculous for these submissions. Oh! What was that? Oh, she got her this time. Emma got her. Look at this shit. I'm in the yellow and she almost has me going. That is bullshit.
Emma is on the attack.
Emma could win this shit here tonight. That's the fucked up part, is I've been beating Emma's ass for fucking like a minute. Emma's only done like five moves on me. Yeah. It could end it.
A lot of punishment inflicted here.
She could fucking end it.
That was some reversal by Tamina.
Oh, belly to belly. She could fucking win right here. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding? No.
This is not the position you want to be in.
No! I'm pressing as fast as I possibly can right now without fucking blowing my fucking arm out.
I'm scared to ask.
Oh! Going for the bow and arrow walk here. Look at this shit. Look at this. Look how much work I had to fucking do to get that. The thing is, Tamina made her tap it on the outside, but the only way you can win is on the inside here. Tamina's gonna have to pull that off again. Oof, my gosh. Jeez.
The WWE Universe letting her hear it.
She's gonna need to dig down deep if she wants to keep going now.
Oh my gosh, right on the fucking back of the post there. Tamina does not care about Emma.
And another shot to the post.
Oh my gosh. She is fucking her day up. Or night, or wherever point we're at this point.
Oh! Man, it looks like a car wreck out there.
No. Oh. Probably the longest match I've had in the night so far. Jeez. Oh.
And it looks like we could be heading back into the ring. And we're going back between the ropes.
Oh, super kick. She got all of it. Oh, Tamina's trying to line her up with it. No. Oh, my gosh. She got all of it there. And she's going for that camel clutch right there. She has it. 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 She tapped out. God damn. I think it's my first submission match I've won in this game. Oh, that is ridiculous. Submission matches are just not fun on hard legend. Ridiculous. If I put on hard, it'd probably be a lot easier, but then the rest of the matches would be 10 times easier as well. What a fucking match, man.
Take a look at the highlights from this match.
She had the thing is she was so close to the ropes too that she was like almost getting it. I was like, she fucking this little midget better not fucking get my shit. Be very upset.
Here is your winner, Tamina.
Tamina is showing her dominance that she's still, you know, relevant, keeping herself relevant here as the NXT Women's Champion at that. The flickering eyebrows, I mean eyelashes there. Anyway, guys, up next, Nikki Bella takes on AJ Lee. I don't know what the fuck's going on with this fucking feud, but whatever. I'll probably let it play out. That's up next. Only on NXT. What the fucking submissions? They make me mad.
Uh-oh. Do you see who's coming out?
The hell is Bray Wyatt doing out here? Yet again. I'm letting this match play out. I haven't let matches play out in a while. I want to see what these two can do. Bray Wyatt is out here for no apparent reason. Maybe I should have played as Wyatt and see if I can fuck around and do some dumb shit. But yeah, Wyatt's out here playing with these two girls here. Well, we saw Nikki win a few weeks ago, and Bray Wyatt came out and was clapping for her. And we saw AJ beat Nikki just last week. And that was fucking weird. So it's just a bunch of mind games, really, as it seems. But at the same time, who is Bray Wyatt cheering for? It really? Who is he really cheering for?
Playing soccer for fast ground and air attacks, and she's not afraid to fight.
Simply easy bulldog keeping her down right now.
Power member of the Bellas.
Oh. Going for those traps.
This girl's cooking.
Wow, that's the first time I've ever heard that one. This girl's cooking. That's really new, and that's scary, Michael Cole. Anyway,
great job of turning that.
These
around.
Two keeping each other at bay with all the moves they can pull out, and Luta is pressed right there. I think these girls are doing better at wrestling than I've been doing in a while. Oh, what the hell?
These two divas are at a standoff here. Hey, wait a minute. She needs to stay focused here.
She shouldn't turn her back.
Wasn't Bray helping? Oh!
Where that happens.
I guess we can see who, what side Bray Wyatt is on here.
That will definitely leave a mark.
That costly distraction has quickly changed the entire momentum of this match. She'll have to find a way to get back into this.
Nikki was a little dazed. She's trying to find herself back here, but it seems like AJ may have the upper advantage at this point.
Is he pressing a secret
button? Regardless of who's on top of who right now.
I mean, those kicks won't give you a good feeling. I can promise you that.
Oh, there we go. Backbreaker to neck breaker. Oh my gosh, going for the pin. 1, 2, 3. Oh, she got the victory. Oh my gosh. So you can see which side or whose side Bray Wyatt's on. Or is Bray Wyatt also playing AJ? Is he just out here to play mind games with these two girls? That was fucking a weird match. But it went by faster than I thought it was really going to go. I thought the match was going to go on forever. Gonna be the quickest fucking NXT I've had in a while.
We got a couple of highlights here. Let's check them out.
I thought I would like give AJ a fucking finisher or something. She just goes for a fucking backbreaker to neck breaker. It's like, oh right, well, that's fine. It just makes sense because you know she got the distraction win.
Look who's come out here, Michael. What an amazing match.
Bray Wyatt associating himself with AJ Lee, and AJ Lee not creeped out at all by Bray Wyatt. That face tells so much of what's going on, and then you can't see AJ, so that's not the point. Anyway, guys, up next, our main event, as Scott Mercury, the Intercontinental Champion, takes on Goldust. Goldust, our Hardcore Champion, one of these two will win. And that's up next, our main event. Don't you dare click away. Get ready for it. Styles are strong out here. Alright, playing as Scott Murray to take on Styles are strong. My game is saving really late for some reason. Anyway, that's not the point. Oh, jeez. Now, at the pay-per-view, fucking Saturday night's main event, Goldust did win his match versus Undertaker and Shawn Michaels. Amazing, in an amazing fashion at that. It was just an amazing match altogether. If you guys haven't seen it, please go check it out. I enjoyed the fuck out of making that. I hope you guys enjoyed the fuck out of watching it. And if you haven't, like I said, if you haven't seen it, please go check it out. If you haven't, comment, like, subscribe on those videos, please go do that. It helps out a lot. Please go comment, like, subscribe on this video here, too, after the match is over. And this is our main event. Styles Strong is on the outside there. Oh.
And that was a costly misstep.
Oh.
These two superstars are at a standoff here. Wait a minute.
He needs to stay focused here. He shouldn't turn his back to his opponent during a match. Oh,
taking advantage there.
That costly.
Well, that drained all my shit. Damn, son.
He'll have to find a way to get back to this fast.
Ouch. That definitely.
My guess is fucking Scott Mercury. Not successful in his match, but Scott, I gotta change that move if he's gonna act the asshole like that. At the same time, Styles Strong lucky in his match versus Macho Man a few nights ago.
Now that's what I call a move. Look at those eyes.
I think Styles Strong did his job here. Oh!
As quickly as he was coming back, it's over just like that.
He's got him.
Goldust really might have this victory here tonight. Or not. DDT. But Scott Mercury is fucking beat here.
He's having a...
Going for it again. Oh, he got it that time. Off the back of Goldust. Kicks to the face. Kicking. He has to stay on him if he wants to win this match. At this point, anything that Goldust can do may cause him the fucking victory here versus Styles Strong. And that's what we gotta watch out for. Goldust is very crafty. He's a very educated wrestler. He knows what he's doing in that ring. He's a veteran at that as well. He's been there long enough to know what and what not to do, and to when to take opportunity. And this guy is all about opportunity. He's won the Hardcore Championship as of recently and beat Undertaker and Shawn Michaels, like I said earlier on. So you got to give this guy credit. He knows what he's doing. And oh my gosh, what a fucking reversal. Scott Mercury, though. Don't count him out just yet. Not until the fucking three is there. He may kick out right there.
He could pin his opponent right here.
Oh!
And look at that expression of pure disbelief on the face of his opponent.
Uh-oh.
I really thought I lost there for a second. I was like, shit. Oh!
Amazing comes up with a counter.
Oh, super kick!
He's heading back up.
I'm spamming as much as I can. Here we go! 3-4-4-50. He may have it here. 1-2-no. And Goldust kicks out. Kicks out. He got him! He needs to get for the three. He needs to go for the three. We are 1-2-3. Oh, and Goldust kicks out of the beauty shot. Are you kidding me? Oh, super kick yet again!
Ooh, a serious knockout blow.
Go for the three again. Two, another two. Goldust staying in this. I don't know how the man's doing it. Oh! Missed! Missed!
He thinks he has it. What an incredible main event this has been.
You gotta give credit. This is main event. It's fucking out of control. Oh. Kick to the midsection yet again. Goldust knows what he's doing here.
Avoids the impact there.
Whoa. What the fuck? Oh, Goldust! Oh, shit. What a fucking match this is. Oh, Scott Mercury with a reversal of his own. Oh, my gosh.
A big time miss.
Oh, shit. I fucked it up. He's going for the pin. Shit.
He may get the three count right here.
No! Goldust somehow, some way still in this, and so is Scott Mercury, which it was even more impressive.
A textbook reversal. Can he follow up? Goldust saw that one coming. Yeah, it's hard getting one past a veteran like Goldust.
Oh, man.
He was one step ahead. There's the cover. Can he do it?
No! Only a two.
Things have clearly gotten worse here for Goldust.
Oh, I was going for the pin, you fucking asshole.
He's going for the pin. This could be it.
Man. Look at this. Oh, and a cutter. It would be all fucking Mercury knees right now to get himself just an open spot. Oh, he got him! He got him! What a win! What a win! Air 2-3! He got him! Oh my gosh, what a fucking match, man. Oh my gosh, that was fucking crazy. I should have stopped jumping as much as I do, because there was times where I'm like, I didn't need to do that. But you know what I mean? You gotta take risks sometimes, but I gotta change a couple moves on Scott anyway. That was cool, like that, like the fucking spinning jump, that jumping tornado DDT. It's glitchy. I don't know why it's so glitchy for him. Like, out of all people, it's weird for him. What a fucking match, man. Goldust was bringing it. You know what I mean? He's taking his opportunities now, and he's in big time main event status right now. You gotta give credit to him, to fucking Mercury, man. You think he's out, and he still fucking finds a way to pop back in. And that's what Styles of Strong has to watch out for. Styles of Strong has a big fucking has a big advantage over of Scott Mercury right now, because he has the advantage of surprise. He can catch the champion off guard, and you have to realize Scott Mercury is champion. Everyone is gunning for that championship gold, including Goldust. Anyway, guys, up next, ECW will be up next, so get ready for that. But I will see you guys when I see you guys. If you guys enjoy this, please comment, like, subscribe. I cannot stress it enough. Leave a comment if you like this shit. Leave a like if you liked it. Leave a fucking subscription if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys at ECW. Oh my gosh, what a fucking night. Next week's gonna be fucking amazing. If you guys haven't seen, what do you call it, Saturday night's main event, please go check it out. I advise you. And I'll see you guys later on this week for ECW. So until then, peace out and good shit. Woo!